Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. I'm Hashim Ali Khan. So this is the last video on cash flow analysis, preparing cash flow statement. So in this video, I'm going to explain you last three problems, 18, 19, 20. So this will be the end of this chapter. If you are regularly watching all my earlier videos, definitely you will get a lot of command on this topic of cash flow statement. It's very important topic for graduates, for postgraduates, and even for professional students like CA, CMS, CS, etc. Now, don't join in between. If you have watched the earlier problems, then only you can be able to understand this. Otherwise, I suggest you to go to the playlist of my channel, select the subject financial statement analysis, select the videos cash flow analysis. Watch the earlier videos, then only you can be able to understand now. So now I'm going to start the next problem, problem number 18. So before starting the problem, I expect my viewers to have a printout of the problems, which I have given in the link under my description. Take a printout and keep it ready. Now 18th problem I'm reading out. From the following information pertaining to Sudhakar Limited, prepare a cash flow statement for the year. So comparative balance sheets are given for 1987-88, 2 years. So traditional form balance sheet is given, liabilities, assets. So equity capital, last year was 1,40,000, current year 1,40,000, no change. No change in equity share capital. Reserves and surplus, last year 74,000, current year 1,05,000. Now we'll see the details regarding reserves and surplus. Nothing is given. Adjustment, it is given, accumulated depreciation was 16,000 at the end of 1987 and 19,000 at the end of 1988. The depreciation provided during the year is 19,000 minus 16,000. 3,000 rupees are depreciation provided. Nothing is given regarding the sale of fixed asset. Now we'll check asset side. You can see fixed assets net last year 90,000, current year 87,000. And in the adjustment, it is given depreciation 3,000. So 90,000 minus 3,000, 87,000. That means there is neither purchase nor sale of fixed asset. No investing activity, no cash flow from investing activity, because there is no purchase, no sale of fixed assets. Now, equity capital, no change. Reserves. Reserves last year 74,000, current year 1,05,000. So we'll take cash flow statement for the current year, for the year ended 31st December 1988, increase in reserves, 1,05,000 minus 74,000, 31,000. The profit earned will be transferred to reserve. So whatever reserves increase, that is due to profit. So this 31,000 is the profit earned. Next, sundry creditor is a current liability, wages outstanding, current liability, miscellaneous expense outstanding, current liability. So all the current liability will consider in working capital adjustments. Now come to asset side. Fixed assets, just now I told you, no purchase, no sale. Then cash, last year and current year cash, last item will take cash and cash equivalent. Sundry debtors, inventory, prepaid rent. These three are the current assets. So three current assets and three current liabilities. All these things will consider in the working capital adjustment. Now, next paragraph, other information, sales are given, cost of goods sold, wages, rent, miscellaneous operating expenses, depreciation 3,000. All these other information we don't require. Only depreciation 3,000 we'll use in writing back non-cash item. That's it. So this is the problem. Very easy problem, simple problem. So first of all, cash flow from operating activities will take the difference in reserves, 31,000. Non-cash, non-operating items. Only one item is there, non-cash item, that is depreciation. Depreciation is provided, that will be added back. The operating profit before working capital adjustments, 34,000. Now adjustments of working capital. Working capital changes. Now current liability. First, you see three current liabilities are the sundry creditors. Last year 32, current year 35,000. Increase in creditors, add. So increase in creditors, add 3,000. Next, wages outstanding. Last year 3,000, current year 4,000. 1,000 rupees wages outstanding increased. So increase in wages outstanding, 1,000, add. Miscellaneous expense outstanding last year 11,000, current year 3,000. Decrease. Decrease in current liability should be deducted. Should be deducted. So here decrease in outstanding expenses minus 8,000. Now come to asset side. Asset side, sundry debtors. Last year 43, current year 40. Decrease in current assets should be added. So decrease in debtors added. Similarly, inventory last year 49,000, current year 58,000. Increase in current assets should be deducted. Increase in current assets deducted. Increase in inventory deduct. Last, prepaid rent. Last year 3,000, current year 5,000. Increase in prepaid rent deduct. Increase in prepaid rent deduct. The only thing you have to remember is increase in current liability, decrease in current assets should be added. You remember this rule. The opposite will be done reverse way. For example, increase in current liability is added, so decrease in current liability will be deducted. Decrease in current asset is added, so increase in current asset should be deducted. These rules you have to remember for adjusting working capital changes. That's it. Almost every problem we are doing. Now, 34,000 plus 3,000 plus 1,000 minus 8,000 plus 3,000 minus 9,000 minus 2,000. 22,000 is the cash profit from operations before income tax. Less income tax. Income tax is not at all given. So 22,000 is the cash generated from operating activities. Now we'll come to the investing activity. There is no investing activity at all. No cash flow from investing activity. Investing activity cash flow will arise whenever there is a purchase or sale of fixed asset or non-current investment. Non-current investments are not there. And fixed assets also, there is neither purchase nor sale. So cash flow from investing activity is nil. Now cash flow from financing activity. For financing activity, we compare the share capital and loans, debentures. Share capital, no change. Last year 140,000, current year 140,000. There are no debentures, there are no loans, no dividend, nothing. So cash flow from financing activity is nil. So this is the first problem where we don't have any cash flow from investing activity. We don't have any cash flow from financing activity. We have the cash flow only from operating activity. So 22,000 is the net increase in cash and cash equivalent. Now cash and cash equivalent at the beginning of the year, see the problem. Last year cash was 75,000. 75,000 was the last year's cash given in the balance sheet. So 75 plus 22, 97,000. We got cash and cash equivalent at the end of the year, 97,000. Now check whether we have done correctly or not. See the balance sheet in the problem. In the problem balance sheet, cash of current year, it is 97,000. I also got 97,000. That means this is the correct cash flow statement. Confirmed, verified. Now, I am coming to the next problem. Problem number 19. From the following information, prepare a cash flow statement of Ruhina Limited for the year ended 31st March 2017. So, we are given the data for 31st March 2016 and 31st March 2017. The liability side, shareholders fund, share capital, last year 1 lakh, current year 1,25,000. So, shares issued during the year, financing activity. So, here, cash flow from financing activity, issue of shares 25,000. I have taken 25. Next, reserves and surplus 33,000, 10,000. We'll see any breakup, any details are given regarding reserves and surplus. Then non-current liability, unsecured loan. Last year loan amount was 20,000. Current year loan amount is 30,000. That means further loan taken. Further long-term loan taken. So it is a financing activity. Unsecured loan taken, 10,000. Financing activity, loan taken. Then next comes current liability. Trade payable, short-term provisions. Both current liability we consider in working capital adjustments. Now come to asset side. Fixed assets. Last year 90,000, current year 1,30,000. That means there is a purchase of fixed asset. And that purchase of fixed asset will take it under investing activity. Afterwards, after completing the problem, we'll see any adjustments are given. Then current assets are inventory, trade receivable. These two current assets we consider in working capital adjustment. Last one, cash and cash equivalent. That is the last item we'll get. Now, additional information is given. Statement of profit and loss of Ruina Limited for the year ended 31st March 2017. Here in this problem, complete profit and loss statement is given. So, revenue from operation 1,50,000. Expenses, purchase of stock in trade, changes in inventories, employee benefit expenses, depreciation and amortization expenses 8,000, other expense 10,000, total expense 1,16,000. So revenue from operations 1,50,000 and total expenses are 1,16,000. So deduct 1,50,000 minus 1,16,000, profit before tax 34,000. Profit before paying the tax is 34,000. Tax expense are 5,000. So profit or loss for the period is 29,000. So additional information, dividend paid during the year 6,000. Now see here, in this problem, complete profit and loss statement is given and how much profit earned before tax is given. Previous problems, it was not given. First time it is given. So what is the profit before tax? 34,000. We will not use the reserves in surplus. We will use the profit and loss statement to find out the operating cash flow from operating expense, operating activities. The profit before tax is 34,000. So I'm starting now. Ruhina Limited cash flow statement for the year ended 31st March 2017. Profit before tax 34,000 is given. Now non-cash, non-operating items. Only one item. Because this profit before tax 34,000 is after charging all expenses, cash as well as non-cash. What is that non-cash? Depreciation. So we add back depreciation. So depreciation 8,000 we add back. So 42,000 is the operating profit before working capital changes. This is the operating profit before working capital changes. Now working capital changes one by one we can take. First one is the trade payable. First one is trade payable. Last year 10,000, current year 25,000. Increase in trade payable add. Increase in trade payable add 15,000. Second, short-term provisions. Last year 4,000, current year 6,000. Increase in short-term provisions add. Increase in short-term provisions add 2,000. Current liability completed. Now current assets, inventories. Last year inventory 10,000, current year inventory 20,000. Increase in current asset should be deducted. Increase in current asset deducted. So increase in inventory deduct 10,000. Similarly, last trade receivable, last year 30,000, current year 50,000. Increase in trade receivable deduct. Increase in trade receivable deduct 20,000. Now 42,000 plus 15,000 plus 2,000 minus 10,000 minus 20,000. So 29,000 is the cash profit from operations before income tax. Before income tax. Now from this we pay the income tax. It is given in the adjustment, profit and loss statement. In the profit and loss statement, it is given tax expense 5,000. So deduct 5,000, 24,000. This 24,000 is the cash generated from operating activities. Now we'll come to the cash flow from investing activities, fixed asset. So fixed asset value is given in the balance sheet. In the balance sheet, it is given fixed assets last year 90,000, current year 1,30,000. Last year 90,000, current year 1,30,000, and depreciation provided is 8,000. So better you make the account fixed asset account. Here fixed assets account debit side to balance brought down opening 90,000, by balance carried down closing 1,30,000. Opening balance debit side and closing balance credit side. Now depreciation, by depreciation 8,000 credit side. Now take the total 8,000 plus 1,30,000, 1,38,000. From 1,38,000, deduct 90,000. Balancing figure is 48,000. This 48,000 is the machinery, fixed asset purchased during the year. This 48,000 is the fixed asset purchased during the year. So to bank, balancing figure 48,000. 48,000. So this purchase of fixed asset will be taken under operating expenses. Cash purchase of fixed asset 48,000 in bracket, because it's a purchase, cash outflow. तो कैश यूज्ड इन इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी माइनस 48,000. नाउ कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिसाइडेड कैपिटल इश्यू ऑफ शेयर्स, 25,000 शेयर्स वर इश्यूड, एंड अनसिक्योर्ड लोन टेकन ड्यूरिंग द ईयर 10,000. डिविडेंड पेड इन द लास्ट लाइन इट इज गिवन डिविडेंड पेड, that dividend paid 6,000 rupees payment, so put it in bracket. Now take the total, 25,000 plus 10,000 minus 6,000, 29,000 is the cash generated from financing activity. Now take the total, 24,000 minus 48,000 plus 29,000, so 5,000 rupees is the net increase in cash and cash equivalent. Now beginning of the year, how much is the cash? It is given in the balance sheet. Beginning of the year it is 14,000. In the balance sheet it is given 14,000, last year's cash. So 14,000 plus 5,000, 19,000 should be the cash and cash equivalent at the end of the year. Now check whether we have done correctly or not. Lastly, current year cash and cash equivalent 19,000 current year. We got 19,000. That means our answer is correct. So we have completed 19 problems on cash flow statement. Come on, now see the last and final problem on cash flow statements. 20th, problem number 20. Following are the comparative balance sheet of Rishad Limited for the year ended 31st March 2016 and 2017. So two balance sheets are given. Share capital. Share capital last year, 2016, it is 5 lakh. And current year it is 6 lakh. So 1 lakh rupees share capital increased. That means issue of shares. Issue of shares will be taken under financing activity. So see here, cash flow from financing activity, issue of shares 1 lakh. So no adjustment, nothing. 1 lakh rupees issue of shares. Reserves and surplus, last year 1,70,000, current year 2,30,000. But we want the breakup. We want the details of these reserves and surplus. So in the notes to accounts, below the balance sheet, notes to accounts, it is given reserves and surplus consist of general reserve. General reserve last year 1,50,000 and current year it is 1,80,000. So during the current year 30,000 rupees are transferred to general reserve. By comparing the general reserve, we can see general reserve has increased by 30,000. How it has increased? During the current year, from the profit 30,000 rupees has been transferred. That transfer, we'll take it here, non-cash item. In non-cash item, transfer to general reserve 30,000, right? Next item, surplus in the statement of profit and loss. So last year surplus in the statement of profit and loss 40,000. Current year it has become 65,000. So there is increase. So I am taking the starting point, increase in surplus in profit and loss statement. Increase in the surplus in profit and loss statement. 65 minus 40, 25,000 is the profit earned during the year. Next, discount on issue of shares. It is a fictitious asset. Discount on issue of share is a fictitious asset. It is deducted from reserves and surplus. So here last year was 20,000. Current year it is 15,000. That means during the current year, 5,000 rupees have been written off. 5,000 rupees have been written off from discount on issue of debentures. So that is a non-cash item. So here I am taking discount on issue of debentures written off. How much was written off? 5,000. Non-cash item. Next comes, after reserves and surplus, non-current liability. The non-current liability consists of debentures. Debentures last year 3 lakh. Current year 2,50,000. So there is redemption of debentures. The redemption of debentures is a financing activity. So here in financing activity, redemption of debentures 50,000. Outflow. Cash is going out, bracket. Next comes current liability, trade payable. Trade payable is a current liability, will adjust in working capital adjustment as usual. Short term provision consists of provision for tax. Here if no provision for tax is given, we would have treated as a current liability. But here specifically given provision for tax. So what is the treatment? Last year's provision for tax is assumed as paid during the current year. And current year's provision for tax will be added as a non-cash item. So current year's provision for tax, how much? 80,000. Provision for tax for current year 2017 is 80,000. So 80,000 I'm adding back. provision for tax current year. Current year is 2017. So current year's provision for tax is 80,000. I'm adding. And last year's provision for tax is 60,000. And that is assumed as paid during the year. So here income tax paid 2016, 60,000. Right? Next comes assets, fixed assets. Fixed assets last year 6,30,000. Current year 6,60,000. Now we'll see the adjustment. Note number 2. In note number 2, it is given fixed assets original cost. Original cost last year was 10 lakh. Current year it is 11,20,000. The fixed assets have increased during the current year. How it will increase? Because of purchase. During the current year, fixed assets are purchased. So here in investing activity. In investing activity, purchase of fixed asset. 11,20,000 minus 10 lakh, 1,20,000 is the outflow. Cash is going out. Purchase of fixed asset. There is neither, there is no sale. There is no sale of fixed asset. Only there is a purchase. Depreciation. Accumulated depreciation last year was 3,70,000. Current year it has become 4,60,000. So accumulated depreciation increased. That means depreciation provided during the year. Depreciation provided. It's a non-cash item. It will be added as non-cash. So here depreciation. So current year 4,60,000, last year 3,70,000. The difference is 90,000 depreciation provided during the year. 90,000. Next comes after fixed asset. What is the next item here? Inventories. Inventories and trade receivable. These two are the current assets. We'll adjust in working capital. That's all. And last, one more note is given. Additional information is given. Surplus as per profit and loss statement. Just now we have seen the surplus as per profit and loss account. Opening balance was 40,000. Current year profit 1,35,000. Total 1,75,000. Out of this 1,75,000, transfer to general reserve 30,000 and dividend paid 80,000. During the year dividend paid. So end of the year surplus remains 65,000. 65,000 is the surplus remaining in profit and loss statement. That is a detail given. From this detail, we come to know only dividend paid is 80,000. That's it. So we have explained you each and every point. Now come to the solution and see. Increase in the surplus in profit and loss statement 25,000. This is the beginning point. Profit. Non-cash, non-operating. In this, first of all, transfer to general reserve as usual will add. Then discount on issue of debentures written off during the year 5,000. Add back. Provision for taxation for the current year 2017 80,000. Depreciation provided during the year, difference in the accumulated depreciation 90,000. And last one, dividend paid. In the last additional information, it is given that during the year dividend is paid for rupees 80,000. Now take the total 3,10,000 is the operating profit before working capital changes. Now adjustment for working capital changes. One by one, current asset and current liability we have to consider. First of all, trade payable. Last year trade payable 1,70,000. Current year it is 1,60,000. Decrease in trade payable deduct. Because the rule is increase in current liability should be added. Decrease in current liability should be deducted. Here decrease. So decrease in trade payable deduct 10,000. Next, provisions already we have taken. Now, asset side, inventories. Inventory is a current asset. Last year 240, current year 370. Increase. Increase in current asset should be deducted. Increase in current asset should be deducted. So, increase in inventory, minus. Similarly, trade receivable last year 2,50,000, current year 2,30,000. Decrease in trade payable, add. Decrease in current asset should be added. So decrease in trade receivable 20,000. That's all. Now 3,10,000 minus 10,000 minus 1,30,000 plus 20,000. You will get 1,90,000. This is the cash profit from operations before income tax. Now less income tax. Last year's provision for tax is assumed as paid during the current year. So how much? 60,000. 2016 provision for tax. Deduct 1,30,000 is the cash generated from operating activities. Cash generated from operating activities. Now cash flow from investing activities. Only one item is the purchase of fixed asset. 1,20,000. Cash flow from financing activity. Issue of shares. Issue of shares 1 lakh. Then redemption of debentures. Just now I told you redemption of debentures 50,000 outflow. And dividend paid 80,000 outflow. That's all. Four. Now you add up. Last one. 1 lakh minus 50,000 minus 80,000. You have minus 30,000. This is the cash used in financing activity. And 1,20,000 is the cash used in investing activity. Now take the total of the last column. 1,30,000 minus 1,20,000 minus 30,000. You will get minus 20,000. This is the net decrease in cash and cash equivalent. To this we add the opening cash. If you see the balance sheet, the cash and cash equivalent at the beginning of the year was 80,000. It is given in the problem. 80,000. Now 80,000 minus 20,000 is 60,000. This is the cash and cash equivalent at the end of the current year 2017. Now we should confirm whether our answer is correct or not. Go to the balance sheet and see the cash and cash equivalent of the current year. Is it 60,000 or not? Yes, it is 60,000. That means our calculations are absolutely correct. Our solution is correct. So you have to remember the important points. Remaining all the points are very simple. Those, every problem, some 2-3 new points you will come across. So focus on those new points. That's it. So 20 problems I have completed. Totally maximum 20 problems I have selected for cash flow statement. Each and every problem I have explained to you in so detailed. So if you are satisfied with my lecture, give a like to the video. Share my channel in your friends, in your groups, so that more students can watch. Not only on this subject, but also on the other subjects which I have uploaded. So you have to go to the playlist. You suggest to your friend circle, your relatives, your groups, that we have so many subjects videos in detail, every video. So first of all, I have explained in detail about the theory, then each and every problem. So watch all these problems with much patience, with full concentration. Then only you can be able to get a lot of knowledge, lot of power from these videos. So give the comments, give your comments on these videos. And lastly, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Inshallah, next I'll make next topic video on this subject of financial statement analysis.